morning. Today I'm going to take about the miscellaneous viruses. These are some viruses which are included in this chapter. So the first one is papaver virus. Papaver virus includes two genera, two important genera. They are polyomavirus and papillomavirus. Okay. This polyomavirus, why it is named? Because it is one of the virus causes, causing the malignant tumors. Polyoma, oma means causative, mean cancerous, either cancerous causative virus, oma means. Okay, it causes multiple types of cancerous condition by these viruses. It includes SV40 virus. Okay, SV is nothing but simian vacillating virus, and another viruses are there. They are human polyoma viruses, JC and BK viruses. And other important genera is papilloma virus. It causes human and animal papilloma viruses. We see the first one, that is HPV. This is HPV is nothing but human papilloma virus. This human papilloma virus is one of the most common cancerous condition that you can see in cervix. Cervix of the cervix is one of the part of the genital organ of the female. Cancerous condition. HPV usually infects the squamous epithelial cells and mucous membrane, resulting in the formation of the warts. First one is, it had been divided into two types, common warts. These are the warts which you'll see in the on the surface of the body. And next one is genital warts, usually found on the genital genital area, genital organs. Common warts are usually found on the hands and feet of the children and adults. And these are caused by two types. They are two serotypes. They are type 1, 2, 3, and 4. These are the these serotypes are responsible for the formation of the common warts. They are nothing but verruca vulgaris. These warts are usually found on the surface of the body. And the genital warts is also called condyloma acuminata. These are usually found on genital organ, external genital organs. They are usually pedunculated warts, caused by serotypes type 6 and type 11, transmitted by venereal route. Sometimes it may usually turn into the malignant. So we are seeing here six types. They are type 1, 2, 3, 4 responsible for the surface of the warts, usually seen on the surface of the hands or feet of the children and adolescent. And genital warts are usually seen on the extragenital organs. Usually pedunculated, the type 6 and 11. Then HPV type 6 and 11 are usually associated intraepithelial neoplasia. Sometimes it may turn into the neoplasia. And next, type 16 and 18 are responsible for cervical cancer. Genital part, one of the genital part of the female. This usually results in the cervical cancer. Cervix cancer and this cervix cancer is usually due to the infection of this virus, that is HPV virus, caused by serotype 16 and 18. Okay, here we have recombinant vaccine also available for HPV infection. It contains the antigens of serotypes 6, 11, 16 and 18. It is indicated in adolescent and young adult women, but it is contraindicated in pregnancy. Okay, so the most important serotypes are 16 and 18, responsible for the cervical cancer. Don't forget about this HPV types 16 and 18. Next, if you see the polyoma, polyoma virus, human polyoma viruses. Here we have animal polyoma viruses and human polyoma virus are also there, but here we are seeing about the human polyoma viruses. These are usually seen whenever the person have an impaired immunity, that is immunodeficient persons. Usually see this type of infection with JC and BK viruses. Antibodies of these viruses are seen almost in 90% of the 90% of the adult set, because infections are occur in childhood itself. It mainly infects the brain and renal tract. Renal tract is infected when the person has any kidney transplantation. In that case, this type of infection can be seen. Okay, usually it leads to if the person have any immunity, if the person have any immune deficiency, it may lead to progressive multifocal leukoencephalopathy or renal disease. Usually the infection is asymptomatic, and the infection and the viruses can be occurred as a latent infection. So infection, whenever the person have any impaired immunity, then only it leads to the progressive multifocal encephalopathy or renal disease. JC virus was isolated from the brain of the patient with Hodgkin's or progressive multifocal leukoencephalopathy. In these cases, JC virus is usually isolated. And these are commonly grown in, only grown in human fetal glial cell cultures only. It grows only in human fetal glial cell cultures. And whenever there is any infection to the brain with this JC virus, glial cell tumors are commonly occurred in these patients. These are nothing but intracerebral tumors in the newborn hamsters. And if you are doing an experimental infection, in that case, intracerebral tumors in the newborn hamsters can usually be seen. And another one is BK virus was isolated from the urine of kidney transplant patients. Okay. This usually grows in the primary cell lines or continuous cell lines. These are less oncogenic when compared to the JC virus. Okay. And next one is parvovirus. Besides this papillomavirus, other virus is parvovirus. It is one of the smallest virus, DNA virus, measures about 20 nanometers in size, which is single stranded. Okay, another important characteristic feature of this parvovirus is for its multiplication, it requires a helper virus, which is totally dependent on that virus. In another way, we can say this virus is a parasite virus. Okay, for its multiplication, it requires a helper virus. This usually found in the blood of symptomless blood donors. First discovered in symptomless blood donors. That is parvovirus B19 virus. It belongs to the family Parvoviridae and genus Erythrovirus. It is worldwide in distribution. And another important characteristic feature is the common clinical manifestations are presented as respiratory infection with the erythematous maculopapular rash and also arthralgia. Commonly known as erythema infectiosum. usually presented as respiratory infection, erythematous, maculopapular rash along with arthralgia. Commonly called as in other way it is called as erythema infectiosa. And another important feature of this parvovirus infection is it can be presented as erythema on the cheeks. So it can be the picture can be seen as slapped cheek. Okay, so it is also called slapped cheek disease. Sometimes you may get a PG question also. The virus which causes the slapped cheek disease is nothing but this parvovirus B19. If you see the spread, it spreads to from trunks to limbs, followed by lymphadenopathy and arthralgia. Usually seen in the age group of 5 to 10 years of old children. It is also called fifth disease. Why it is called fifth disease? Because in the old list of exanthematous fever, it is listed as fifth one. Parvovirus B16 is included as a fifth disease. Okay? And a fifth disease and include chesar kabatti, exanthematous fevers of children low. It is also called a fifth disease. It induces the aplastic crisis, aplastic anemia. Aplastic anemia in children and also chronic hemolytic anemia in sickle cell disease. In immunodeficient children, it can be seen as it can be presented as persistent anemia, and if it infects the pregnant lady, that to be in second or third stage of pregnancy, it causes the fetal high drops. Okay, fetal high drops usually transmitted by the respiratory route. Diagnosis is usually detected by using the sample, that is blood. Okay, blood in early phase, later by detection of the antibodies by taking the serum. Antigen can be detected earlier of the infection. And next one is after this parvovirus infection, another important infection is germinal measles. This is also called as rubella. Here you have to differentiate with the measles causing virus. That measles causing virus is also called rubella virus. Rubella. Here it is. Here this rubella is also called as German measles. Here it is characterized by macular rash and lymphadenopathy. Okay, it is only a transient erythematous macular papillomacular rashes with lymphadenopathy. It is only a transient in case of adults. But if it infects, if it infects the pregnant lady, it leads to congenital malformations of the fetus. Commonly can be presented as a triad of cataract, deafness, and cardiac defects. Rubella infection వచ్చినప్పుడు ఒకవేళ కన్జెంటల్ మాల్ఫార్మేషన్స్ వచ్చినప్పుడు ఈ ట్రయడ్స్ వస్తాం అన్నమాట ఏంటి కాట్రాక్ట్ డెఫినెస్ అండ్ కార్డియాక్ డిఫెక్ట్స్ యూజువల్లీ కన్జెంటల్ మాల్ఫార్మేషన్స్ ఆల్సో డిపెండ్స్ అపాన్ ద స్టేజ్ ఆఫ్ ద ప్రెగ్నెన్సీ ఆల్సో If it infects in the first trimester, the first stage of the pregnancy, it leads to 90% of the congenital malformations. So many organs are involved. 90% of the fetus is affected. If it infects in the later life, only communication defects are seen, like communication defects like nose bridge, ఏమైనా డిఫెక్ట్స్ కమ్యూనికేషన్ డిఫెక్ట్స్ అనేవి వస్తాయి కదా డెవలప్మెంటల్ స్టేజ్ లో అవి చూస్తాం అన్నమాట. అండ్ ఇట్ కెన్ బి ప్రెజెంటెడ్ యాజ్ యూజువల్లీ ప్రెజెంటెడ్ యాజ్ ప్రెజెంటెడ్ విత్ కెటరాక్ట్ డెఫ్నెస్ అండ్ కార్డియాక్ డిఫెక్ట్స్. సమ్ టైమ్స్ ఇన్ సివియర్ కేసెస్ ఇట్ ఈస్ ఆల్సో అసోసియేటెడ్ విత్ అదర్ ఫీచర్స్ లైక్ లింఫెడెనోపతి, థ్రాంబోసైటోపెనియా, థ్రాంబోసైటోపెనిక్ పర్పుర. Other defects are also seen. This is also called expanded rubella syndrome. Okay, expanded rubella syndrome ananta common congenital malformations aithe kanka triad untadi cataract, deafness and cardiac defects are usually we see. This is the picture showing the measles virus, which is it may be a spherical or pleomorphic in size, pleomorphic in shape. It's a pleomorphic in shape, spherical. Sometimes it measures about 50 to 70 nanometers in size, contains single stranded RNA genome, and consists of hemagglutinin papillomas, which aggregates the human or goose erythrocytes at 4 degrees centigrade. It is the only one virus belongs to the classified under the family Taugaviridae. It is only one member, member of the genus of Ruby virus, and this is inactivated by ether, chloroform, formaldehyde, beta propiolactam and deoxycholate, and destroyed by heating at 56 degrees centigrade, survives for several years at minus 60 degrees or 70 degrees minus 70 degrees centigrade. If you see the cultivation and host range, usually grows in primary cell lines or continuous cell lines like rabbit kidney or BHK21 or Vero cell lines. The growth can be detected by cytopathic effects like interferons, identified by interferons using a challenge virus like ECHO-12 virus. Okay. ECHO virus means enteric causing orphan virus, ECHO 11 virus. If you see the clinical features, usually transmitted by inhalation, incubation period is almost 2 to 3 weeks, affects children, and manifestations are rash. Yeah? Rash can be disappears within 3 days, whereas in measles, it usually lasts for about 1 week. In this case, only it lasts for 3 days only, sparing palms and soles. And along with the erythematous maculopapular rashes, supposedly cervical lymph nodes are also, lymphadenopathy is also seen with the non-tender enlargement. Here, in this case, complex spots are absent. This is one differentiating point of the measles virus, measles virus. In that measles virus, bluish white ulcers usually seen buccal mucosa. Okay, buccal mucosa that to be lower molar tooth, opposite to the molar tooth. Okay, here in this case, complex spots are absent. If you see the laboratory diagnosis, usually in normal people, it is a transient. Sometimes it can be asymptomatic. Sometimes in mild erythematous rashes can be seen. But it is severe. If it infects a pregnant lady, it causes a severe infection, like causing congenital malformations. For laboratory diagnosis in case of pregnancy, usually diagnosis of this virus can be done by means of isolation and serological diagnostic test by using the samples of blood and throat swabs. The cell lines that are usually taken are rabbit kidney cell lines or Vero cell lines. Growth can be obtained. Growth can be observed by interference. By using the challenge virus, that is ECHO-11 virus. In case of serology, If you detect the IgM, indicates acute infection, and if you detect the IgG infection, that is a chronic infection. Vaccination is available by using the triad vaccine, that is MMR vaccine. Congenital rubella, in case of for congenital rubella, diagnosis can be obtained by using the samples of urine or blood. Nasal swabs like that. Demonstration of IgM in the newborn indicates itself the fetus is infected with this rubella. Paired sera from mother and child demonstrate the rise tide, fourfold rise of the titer indicates the patient is infected with the rubella infection. If you see the prophylaxis, single infection lasts for immunity. Lasting immunity because of the presence of only one antigenic type. We have vaccine that is live attenuated vaccine, which is attenuated by serial passages in the in the cell cultures. It can be given MMR, that will be subcutaneous infection, subcutaneous injection, which is contraindicated in immunodeficient people, individuals, and in pregnancy also. Another most important topic, that is slow virus diseases. This is very important. Sometimes you may get as a short notes. Okay, so you may get as short notes or very short notes. These slow viruses disease is it's a group of diseases causing infection to humans and animals. Important characteristic feature is it has a very long incubation period. That means it may extend to 2 to 3 years or 5 years also. That's why it is a slow virus infection, and progressed to relentlessly course of terminating fatally. Finally, it leads to death only. It is classified as group A, B, and C. Okay, classified as group A, B, and C. These are important characteristic features. These are some of the important characteristic features of the slow virus diseases. Incubation period ranging from months to years. Okay, course of illness lasting for months or years with the remissions and exacerbations. Okay. Remissions and exacerbations. The immunity of the individual is good. Good infection is subsided. If there is any deficiency in the immunity, you may see the exacerbations. The remissions and exacerbations. And it has more predilections to involvement of the central nervous system. And here there is no involvement of the CMA and HMI, that is central cell mediated immunity and humoral mediated immunity is not involved in this case. Usually there is a genetic predisposition. Finally, it leads to death only. If you see the group A, it includes serologically related non-oncogenic retroviruses, that is lentivirus. Here, this lentivirus includes AIDS virus. If you see this HIV virus, human immunodeficiency virus, it is a slow disease. That's why it is included under group A. HIV chuste kanaka attested person is not affected. Slowly he may be deteriorated. That's why this HIV is included under the group A. Next one is group B. Group B includes prion diseases of the central nervous system. It includes scrapie, mink encephalopathy, Crutchfield, Jakob disease, is collectively called subacute spongiform viral encephalitis. Okay. Next, group C consists of two unrelated CNS diseases of humans. They are SSPA, that is subacute sclerosing paraencephalitis, and another one is progressive multifocal encephalopathy. And these two CNS diseases are grouped under this C. We see the group A. Group A includes Visna. It is a disease of sheep contains a demyelinating disease of the central nervous system. Incubation period is almost 2 years. Symptoms are paresis, which may progress to paralysis and death. Finally, death. MEDI is a it's also a disease of respiratory tract. In severe cases, it leads to progressive pneumonia. And if you see the group B diseases, that is slow virus diseases, Stanley B. Prusner gave the name prion. Okay, prion is nothing but a proteinaceous infectious agent. Prion is nothing but a proteinaceous infectious agent. It is mainly due to the accumulation of the abnormal proteinaceous material from the abnormal proteinaceous accumulation and proliferation of the abnormal proteinaceous material. It is devoid of DNA and RNA. Okay, it includes subacute spongiform viral encephalitis. Chronic progressive degenerative disease of the CNS, central nervous system. It is mainly due to the vacuolation in the dendrites of the neurons and axonal dendrites of the neurons. Dendrites and the axonal process of the neurons. Sometimes it may involve astroglial cells also. Leads to hypertrophy and proliferation. Leads to spongiform degenerative disease in the gray matter. Okay, it's one of the important central nervous system which is included under the prions. It doesn't have any signs of inflammation or immune response. It is a proteinaceous in nature and devoid of DNA or RNA. It is very important characteristic feature. Usually virus or bacteria, anything will contain DNA or RNA. Here in this case, pathology is mainly due to the abnormal accumulation of proliferation of the abnormal proteinaceous material. Okay, act as an infectious agent. These are resistant to physical and chemical agents like heat, irradiation, formalin. It is mainly due to the proliferation of the abnormal prion protein derived from the normal protein, which accumulates in the CNS, results in the deposition on the deposits in the forms of plaques, disrupting the very architecture of the organ, disrupting the architecture and functioning in the brain and causing the disease. Okay. If you see the prion diseases of the animals, previously had seen. We had seen the prion diseases of the humans, and you see the prion diseases of the animals. The first one is scrapie. It is a prototype of prion disease. It is a disease of the sheep. Next one is mink encephalopathy. This scrapie disease, sheep acquires the disease from ewe to lamb. Mink acquires the infection when they fed with scrapie infected sheep. Next disease is bovine spongiform encephalopathy. It is also called mad cow disease. MADCO disease. This is here. This is also acquired infection by acquired infection cattle by feeding them scraby infected meat. I forgot to tell one important point in prion disease of animals. That is Stanley B. Prusner. Here the person had given this Stanley B. Prusner. Is the person had given the prion. Okay. Don't forget that Stanley B. Prusner. Next one is human prion diseases. There are all characteristic features. Previously I told you there are all characteristic features. After animal prion diseases, here we have human prion diseases. Here, human prion diseases are consists of Creutzfeldt Jakob disease, CJD, Gressman-Strasler-Shinker syndrome. Next one is Kuru. Next one is fatal familial insomnia. These four are the human prion diseases due to the abnormal due to the accumulation of the proliferation of the abnormal protein, proteinaceous infectious agent in the brain or central nervous system. If you see the Creutzfeldt-Jakob disease, it's a subacute presenile encephalopathy, which leads to which progresses to incoordination and dementia, which ends fatally in about a year. Okay, here in this case, Creutzfeldt-Jakob disease, the individual may suffer from incoordination and dementia. And next one, next thing is iatrogenic CJD may acquire this iatrogenic may be due to the corneal transplantation or injection of the pituitary growth hormone. A new variant of CJD had been seen in Britain, which raised fear of infection by eating this BSV bovine spongiform encephalopathy, which is infected with beef. This was stopped by slaughtering of all the beefs at that time. Thereby this disease has been stopped. Next one is human prion. Human prion disease, that is Kuru. Kuru is nothing but means tremor. Is nothing but tremor. This disease is seen in tribals of New Guinea. It is characterized by cerebellar ataxia tremors, chance by fatally in 3 to 6 months. These tribals had acquired this Kuru due to the ritual of eating relatives' dead bodies without cooking. This is nothing but a cannibalism. Infection is mainly due to the cannibalism. Okay, those tribes have a ritual of eating the eating the relatives' dead bodies without sterile cooking. This infection has abolished by stopping this cannibalism. This Kuru disease was first observed by Carlton Gottsek during the period of 1976. Because of that, he got the Nobel Prize also for contribution on Nobel Prize in Medicine for contribution on Kuru. When they stopped this cannibalism, this Kuru disease had been abolished. Next disease, that is Group C. It includes slow virus disease, that includes subacute sclerosing pancreatitis. It's a very rare disease. This subacute sclerosing pancreatitis is a very rare disease. It's a sequel of the Measles disease. That to be the persons infected with persons who had infection with measles may have immunodeficiency. In that case, this may reactivate and can be progressed to subacute sclerosis and paroxysmalitis. Usually, sets in many years after the initial infection, it is characterized by deterioration of matter and motor functions. This measles antigens is observed by serological tests also, serological tests, and also by using the electron microscope. And a high level of antibodies are also seen in serum and also in CSF. CMI, cell mediated immunity to measles virus, is absent. Okay. Next one is progressive multifocal leukoencephalopathy. It is characterized by subacute demyelinating disease seen in elderly person whose immunity is impaired. It progresses to a deterioration of motor functions, vision, speech. That can be seen in about 3 to 4 months. Next one is viral hemorrhagic fevers. These viral hemorrhagic fevers are zoonotic in nature, caused by arena virus and filovirus. They are usually localized in South America and Africa. This arena virus are enveloped, contains vectors and single stranded RNA. Under the electron microscope picture, they can be seen as grains of sand causing chronic infection in rodents. It's a prototype. LCM is a prototype. That is lymphocytic chorioamenorrheitis is a prototype. Humans acquire infection by means of excreta of rodents. Usually asymptomatic, can be seen as influenza-like illness or meningitis transmitted vertically. This arenavirus causing hemorrhagic fevers are of two types, three types. They are Argentina, Bolivia, and Lassa fever. This Lassa fever is seen in Nigeria. It's noticed in 1969, transmitted by excreta. Person-to-person transmission is mainly by droplets, usually present in the throat and blood. Ribavirus is a treatment of choice. Next, if you see the filoviruses, they are long thread-like viruses. Okay, these are not spherical in shape or pleomorphic in shape. These are long thread-like viruses, measures about 80 to 800 nanometers in size. It includes Marburg and Ebola virus. Belongs to the genus filovirus. These two viruses are the important causative agents. Belongs to the filovirus. Marburg virus is one of the hemorrhagic virus, one of the causative agent of hemorrhagic fever. Who are working in the labs? In the first identified in the Germany, that is during the period of 1967, when they are exposed to the African green monkey. When they are exposed to the cell culture lines of African green monkeys. These viruses are isolated from the blood and tissues in the guinea pigs and tissue cultures. This is the picture showing the long filamentous structure, that is filovirus. Next one is Ebola virus. First observed this Ebola virus infection was observed during the period of 1976, occurred in Sudan and Zaire, besides the river of Ebola. Strains of Ebola virus are Zaire strain, Sudan strain, and Restron strain are there. These three strains are responsible for the Ebola virus infection. And next one is coronavirus. What we are seeing nowadays is due to the coronavirus. These are spherical and pleomorphic in shape. It is a RNA virus containing petal or club-shaped papillomers. The name refers to the surface projection resembles solar corona, hence the name coronavirus. It contains two groups, acid level and acid stable. acid level causes the common cold. Acid stable causes the gastroenteritis. This is first isolated in a human embryonic trachea. Human embryonic trachea. This is the picture showing the coronavirus. Solar corona. I mean, appears like solar appearance. That's why it is also called coronavirus. Next, SARS also included under this. It is SARS is nothing but severe acute respiratory syndrome. First observed in the period of 2002. First described by Dr. Carlo Arbani in China, in South China, and he identified it as a causative agent of new epidemic, and he got the early, he initiated early steps for its control, and died because of its infection within a month also. It is assigned as coronavirus type 4 and can be identified by using the electron microscope picture, and growth can be seen by using the mirror cell lines. Spreads by, this SARS is spread by usually by inhalation. This is SARS clinically manifested as fever, cough, and progresses to pneumonia. Death is mainly due to respiratory failure. Can be identified. Diagnostic methods are also available. They are ELISA, indirect immunofluorescence test, and molecular tests like RT-PCR is also available. There is no specific therapy or prophylaxis. And next one is Rioviridae. The family derives its name from respiratory enteric heartworm virus. It is a double-shelled icosahedral in shape. Measures about 55 to 57 nanometers in size. Another important characteristic feature is it is double-stranded RNA virus. Important characteristic feature. Double-stranded RNA virus. It's a non-envelope, resistant to lipid solvents. It has three genera. Rheovirus, Arbivirus. Arbivirus contains tick fever caused by Colorado tick fever, and another important genus is Rotavirus. We see the Rotavirus, it is a double-walled virus, appears like a wheel. The electron microscope picture, it appears as a wheel, little wheels with the short spokes arising from the central hub. With a clearly defined rib, outer rib. It is complete when it is double-shelled, and if it is single-shelled, that is incomplete. This is one of the important causes of viral disease of the infants and children. Outbreaks is also seen in older children and adults also. This is a picture showing the rotavirus. It's one of the important causative agent of the diarrheal disease in case of infants. If you see the laboratory diagnosis of the rotavirus, is diagnosed by electron microscope. Serological methods are also there, are also available. They are detection of the IgM and IgG in blood. So many serotypes are there. Serotype or antigen groups are there from A to Z. Disease is a self-limiting. Treatment is oral rehydration. Rotavirus vaccine is also available. Other viruses causing the diarrhea are Norfolk virus. It is a small round RNA virus included in Calciviridae. Here it contains a cup-like depressions on the surface. Adenovirus, that could be serotypes 40 and 41 are responsible for the diarrhea. Astrovirus, also one of the causative agents of diarrhea. It is a short star shape, measures about 28 nanometers in diameter. And coronavirus, that to be as a stable type is one causative agent of gastroenteritis. This completes the miscellaneous viruses. Thank you.